On January 28, 2012, Archbishop Stanisław Nowak, Metropolitan of Częstochowa, presided over a ceremony at the Chapel of the Miraculous Image of Our Lady of Częstochowa at Jasna Góra, during which the protection of the civilization of life and love in the world was entrusted into the loving hands of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary. The ceremony included touching a copy of the Częstochowa icon to the original and blessing the copy. This copy is dedicated to the protecting of human life and will be carried in pilgrimage from ocean to ocean, from Vladivostok, Russia, passing through Asia and Europe, and ending in Fatima. Leaders of pro-life movements of 17 countries, Austria, Belarus, Czech Republic, Spain, Kazakhstan, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Portugal, Russia, Slovakia, Switzerland, Ukraine, Hungary, Great Britain, Italy, and USA participated in the ceremony.
Ta ikona z kopią jasnogórskiej 1:1 i jest przeznaczona dla ruchu pro-life w Rosji, dla prawosławnego ruchu pro-life. I jest też takim symbolem.
The pilgrim icon is a one-to-one copy of the Częstochowa icon intended for the pro-life movement in Russia, for the Orthodox pro-life movement. Our Lady of Częstochowa is a pro-life symbol. We, representatives of pro-life movements from various countries, want to entrust the defense of the civilization of life and love into the hands of Our Lady. By ourselves, we cannot be successful. We need help. Mary is with us. She gives us encouragement and this icon was created in a very special way. I traveled to Russia and there I first encountered the cult of the Częstochowa icon in the Orthodox tradition. This had an impact on me, and I was moved to provide a copy of the Częstochowa icon to pro-life movements in Russia, along with pro-life prayer. According to a prophecy of one of the great Orthodox saints, in order for Russia to return to God, the patriarch must pray before the icon of Częstochowa. I was deeply affected when I read about this. The Częstochowa icon is present in the Orthodox Church and also in Orthodox homes. It is venerated as one of the oldest icons, as an icon written by St. Luke. It is as if she united us. The East has a very lively devotion to Mary, and we also have an ardent devotion to Mary. This icon brings us together. I know that Russia was given copies of the Częstochowa icon on many occasions, but this one is entrusted specifically to the pro-life movement, so that every child that is conceived in any country, no matter where, would be born, so that every child would be loved, would be happy, and would develop normally to serve the Lord. Our dream is to take this icon, together with our prayers, across all of Russia, from Vladivostok through Kazakhstan, Ukraine, Belarus, Lithuania, Latvia, Poland, Slovakia, Czech Republic, Hungary, Austria, Germany, France, and Spain, to Portugal, to Fatima. It appears possible that this dream can be fulfilled, but it is still under discussion. The case is open. One can see that there is a need for this in the hearts of people who defend life, and thus defenders of life from many countries have come to Częstochowa.
The pro-life leaders first met at the house honoring the memory of the great Polish primate Stefan Kardynał Wyszyński.
Ksiądz kardynał Stefan Wyszyński modlił się za kraje
wschodu. Kardynał Stefan Wyszyński prayed for the countries of the East. Let me quote a small part of one of his prayers. We will go with you, Mother, to the far east, beyond the borders of our homeland, to countries in distress, Belarus, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, Ukraine, Caucasus, Romania, Bulgaria, Czechlands, Hungary, and others. For all these nations call you blessed according to your prophetic vision. O Holy Mother, may their faith be not in vain. May they be rewarded and strengthened in faith by your special intervention, and may the suffering of people of faith be ended. I was overcome by emotions over this concern expressed by Cardinal Wyszyński for the living faith of all. The journey which is about to begin is for me the fulfillment of his desires, the fulfillment of what he wanted most. And I think that now, looking down from heaven, he is certainly very happy that the pilgrimage of Our Lady, in the image of Our Lady of Jasna Góra, which he loved so much, is about to begin. He often said that he never made a mistake on one road, the road to Jasna Góra. He certainly is rejoicing that in this image she will go through the world and will truly be the mother of life. She will give birth to new life.
Że pójdzie przez świat, że będzie naprawdę matką życia, że ona odrodzi nowe życie.
Here in the chapel, during the liturgy of the word, the journey of Częstochowa icon or the defense of the civilization of life and love was encircled in prayer.
I would like to thank all those persons who so full of zeal and faith arranged this meeting. I thank all members of Human Life International for their efforts in preparing this meeting. Our presence, people from so many countries and languages, testifies to the fact that we want to pray for peace and we know how great a gift it is. May Mary, the Mother of God, help our efforts to ensure that peace will prevail in our hearts and throughout the world.
Kiedy nadszedł wreszcie dzień pięćdziesiątnicy, znajdowali się wszyscy razem na tym samym miejscu. Nagle dał się słyszeć z nieba szum, jakby uderzenie gwałtownego wiatru i na pewno się
And the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus and his disciples were called to the marriage.
На третій день був брак в Кані Галілейській, і матір Ісуса була там. Був також званий Ісус і ученики його на брак.
Omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
At the same time, in a separate room, the Orthodox priest presided over prayers for the same intention. After the ceremonies, the participants gathered in the conference room where talks and discussion took place in a family atmosphere. Ultimately, a coordinating committee was created for the planning pilgrimage.
When we started this program, I thought that it would be impossible to bring everyone together here. But it turns out that Częstochowa is not that far away and everyone was able to come. I would like to greet Father Peter West, who is the Vice President of Human Life International.
Volokolamsk Metropolitan Hilarion, Chairman of the Department of External Relations of the Moscow Patriarch of the Orthodox Church, sent the committee a letter of greetings and support for the blessed work of the pilgrimage of the Częstochowa icon for the defense of life.
At the beginning, I would like to emphasize that I am not the author of this idea. In this case, it did not originate here. It does not come from the human world. I can only be an intermediary through whom this idea comes into our land.
I think that we are participating in an incredible initiative in which the icon of Our Lady of Częstochowa will visit lands that in the recent past have been affected by many difficult problems, where many lives were lost during the Second World War, and where even today many lives are being lost on account of the right to abortion. The intention of the pilgrimage of the Mother of God in her icon is to unite around herself people of different religions and denominations, thus showing that as Christians we are one, that we really want to discover God in all the happiness in our lives. I think that Mary, as the mother of the God-man, Jesus Christ, unites all and helps us to discover this childhood of God. Above all, she helps us to rejoice at the meeting in Częstochowa, even though we speak different languages and come from different countries. But what unites us is the image of Our Lady of Częstochowa, who cares for her children. I've seen in the first few minutes of the meeting people who are praying together, being together, talking the pro-life initiative. And I think it will be an amazing thing, as one of the speakers remarked, that she will deepen the spiritual life of those who accept the Mother of God. It will also lead to publicizing the culture of promoting life. As the Mother of God passes through the many different countries, many different dioceses, many different cultures, the common denominator will always be love of God and promoting the culture of life. Mary rejoices in life and promotes life by giving birth to Jesus Christ. I think that we have to emphasize this in our pro-life activities. We are for life. Salve Regina, Mater
Misericordiae. Otrzymując zaproszenie na spotkanie do Częstochowy, nie zdawałem sobie sprawy, że
when I received the invitation to come to the meeting in Częstochowa, I never thought that so many representatives of different countries would be here to talk together about defending life and to deliberate on the idea of a pilgrimage, of a copy of the icon of Our Lady of Częstochowa, from one ocean to another, from Vladivostok to Fatima. Along the route is Kazakhstan, where I have been working for a long time. The idea of a pilgrimage of the Mother of God has incredible meaning to us. It shows that we are not alone, that pro-life issues are important not only in Kazakhstan, but also in Russia, Ukraine, Belarus, Poland, Portugal, and throughout Europe. The very idea of a pilgrimage of the Mother of God, regardless of the form it takes, seems very important, because it is a matter of not only the presence of the icon, but also the actual presence of Our Lady. We realize that she truly will be there, where at any given time we gather to greet her. Kazakhstan is open to this idea and looks forward to the visit of Mother of God. I think that not only the Catholic Church, but also the Orthodox Church will open its doors to meet Mary, who is coming.
Na spotkanie Maryi, która przychodzi.
Относительно готовящегося уже на сегодняшний день крестного хода с
the upcoming journey of Our Lady of Częstochowa, it is an event important to the whole Christian world. The icon of Mother of God, as Igor Beloborodov said, unites East and West. This icon, which the Western Church protects, has indulged many twists and turns throughout history. In our history, there have been many tragedies, many tears and errors in announcing Christ's teaching. But nevertheless, it is our desire to find love in Christ. We see that the world is moving away from the Church and is becoming closed to the proclamation of the Gospel.
But that is only a first impression, because this pilgrimage is a way of bringing out the soul of the nation. It is not an organizational issue. Those are secondary and will appear later. This calling always comes from the heart, but we cannot predict how the seed of God's truth will grow where it has been sown. I am convinced that carrying out the action will be complicated, but it will yield great good fruit. Many people who hear about this will see the Mother of God when her icon is carried from one ocean to the other, from the Pacific to the Atlantic, and all those people will experience their own birth. They will sense that they are God's creation, whom God loves unconditionally, regardless of their nationality or religion, or membership in other small interest groups.
Другие мелкие группы по тем или иным интересам.
My czasem zadajemy sobie pytanie, czy chodzi o peregrinację ikony, czy o peregrinację Matki Bożej. I właściwie nasi bracia prawosławni mają łatwiejszą odpowiedź, dlatego że rozumienie ikony...
We sometimes ask ourselves whether this is a journey of the icon or the journey of the Virgin Mary. Actually, our Orthodox brothers have an easier answer, because the Orthodox Church understands icons as a sacramental presence. And hence, the icon before which a person stands is an open window or a door for meeting, for a real encounter with the Lord, with Mother of God, with Jesus. The icon of Our Lady, or we often say icon rather than picture, comes from the East and is known in the East. One could ask this group of people which is connected with the family and with the protection of life, the question of who can gather people around herself in the most beautiful way? The answer will certainly be a mother. If Mary is the Mother of God, if Mary is our mother, regardless of the country of our birth, or our religion, or faith, whoever knows how to find the way to our mother will find the road to a safe life. That person is under her protection, cloaked in her concern for him, the concern of the one who cares for her son, who leads him to Golgotha. She is with him always. And finally, she is with the risen Jesus, or rather, gives us the power of the risen one. And as Father summed up, the travel of the Mother from the Pacific to the Atlantic Ocean is a great hope for all those children who wish to see her presence in their lives.
Które zechcą zobaczyć jej obecność w swoim życiu.
The transfer of Our Lady of Częstochowa icon from the chapel of the Cardinal Stefan Wyszyński house to the monastery of Jasna Góra was accompanied by silent prayer of the participants of this unique procession. An unexpected occurrence took place when the icon was brought into the basilica of the monastery. The Jasna Góra orchestra, which was preparing for a performance at the time, sounded a fanfare. With such a stately accompaniment, the icon was brought to the sacristy, from where the Pauline Fathers, led by the curator of the Częstochowa icon, Father Melchior Królik would take the icon to the cloister of the monastery. There, in the house chapel, without outside witnesses, the copy of the icon was ceremonially attached to the original. After that, the copy was placed in the presbytery of the Chapel of the Miraculous Image and the Holy Mass began. Archbishop Stanisław Nowak, Metropolitan of Częstochowa, presided over the Eucharist. In welcoming to the spiritual capital of the Poland, the pro-life representatives of 17 countries who launched the International Committee of the Pilgrimage of the Icon earlier that day, he said,
"Welcome, beloved defenders of life. You are truly welcome in this role. You are people of great credit. What unites us is the great concern for life, for human life and dignity. We all want to entrust this mystery to God and beg Him that man may be saved and protected by Mary."
Czytanie z Księgi Apokalipsy świętego Jana Apostoła. Świątynia Boga w niebie się otwarła i Arka Jego Przymierza ukazała się w Jego świątyni. Potem ukazał się wielki znak na niebie. Niewiasta obleczona w słońce i księżyc z stopami, a na jej głowie wieniec z gwiazd 12.
In his homily, Archbishop Stanisław Nowak pointed out the value of human life. In a decisive and unequivocal way, he said,
"Godzi się, żeby nasza przedobra matka w kopii ikony jasnogórskiej poświęcona dziś tu, w tym niezwykłym miejscu..."
It is proper that our good mother, in the copy of the Częstochowa icon, which was consecrated today and touched to the original sacred icon in this remarkable place at Jasna Góra, will travel through the world, specifically through Asia and Europe, touching people's hearts and conscience. Oh, how good it is that Mary, in her motherly way, will speak and plead directly to people's hearts, asking them, "People, respect life, save every man, do not dare to destroy or kill them. It is not permitted to manipulate human life or trade it. After all, human life is the great gift of God Himself, the eternal being, the Creator and Lord of man, who, in the words of Jesus Christ, called Himself life. I am the way, the truth, and life." It is not surprising that our sister Orthodox Church considers this a special icon and even calls her the icon of the end times. Our expectations of this pilgrimage from ocean to ocean are, as we say, from the Pacific to the Atlantic, are very high. We trust that Our Lady of Częstochowa will penetrate our hearts and conscience, that she will speak from the image firmly and resolutely, "Thou shall not kill, it is not permitted." On the contrary, she will rebuke and say, "Defend, save, educate, love, with true and complete love that is not self-centered." She will also show the scars on her face and warn against shedding innocent blood.
This slogan of the journey from ocean to ocean will remind us of the command to proclaim the gospel to all creation. Go through the whole world and proclaim the gospel to all creation. Pray for all the movements that are working with so much zeal and dedication for the defense of life and dignity of the transmission of life.
Działające tak gorliwie i z poświęceniem w obronie życia i godności przekazywania życia.
Let us pray for bishops and priests that looking to the Blessed Virgin Mary, they maintain their strength in the struggle to preserve faith in Christ and always courageously defend human life. We pray to the Lord.
Wysłuchaj nas, Panie.
Lūk mēs par dzīvības aizstāvības organizāciju visās pasaules valstīs, lai tās ar lielu upuru gatavību un mērķiecību aizstāvētu cilvēku dzīvību no ieņemšanas brīža līdz dabiskai nāvei. Mēs Tevi lūdzam.
Vesūkai nas, Panie.
Unsere Familien stehen heute fortan unter Beschuss. Auf die Fürsprache des seligen Papstes Johannes Paul II. Lasst uns beten für unsere verheirateten Eheleute, dass sie die Treue zu Gott und sich zu sich gegenseitig wahren können und dass ihre Familien und die ungeborenen Kinder beschützen. Wir bitten dich, erhöre uns.
Besuche in Spanien.
La propagande pour l'euthanasie utilise le mensonge d'une bonne mort. Prions pour les personnes qui sont déprimées ou en phase terminale de leur maladie. Prions qu'ils maintiennent leur dignité à l'heure de leur mort et l'espérance en Dieu qui nous donne la vie. Prions le Seigneur.
Kultūra života a lásky, kde je jediná šance záchrany světa. Modlíme se za nás, aby jsme vždy odvážně stáli na straně kultury života a lásky, chránit život nejmenší a bezbraný. Těba prosím.
Vysouhaj nás, Páně.
Almighty eternal God, we adore you and glorify you. You have done great things for the Blessed Virgin Mary, choosing her to be the mother of your Son and our Savior. She became blessed among women because she believed that the word spoken to her by the Lord will be fulfilled. Bless, O Lord, this image. May it remind us that Mary is the mother of Christ and our mother, to whom we can flee in every need. Make us follow Christ, our Lord, as she did.
Spraw także, abyśmy Jagona naśladowali z Chrystusa, Pana naszego.
Pryswytaja Dzieła Maria, Pryczysta Bogorodzica, Ciebie przypomnijmy najważniejsze dzieło, защиту цивилизации жизни и любви. Мы живем в трудные времена, мощнейшие атаки цивилизации смерти. Погибает множество невинных беззащитных людей, дети, не успев родиться, старики, немощные, больные. Число жертв уже превысило 2 миллиарда человеческих жизней.
Each day, an additional 50,000 children die in their mother's womb. Many people do not want to have children at all. Means of destroying fertility and life are becoming more and more common. Infertility of married couples is increasing. The human child is becoming a product of modern technology, of donor cells and organs. Children are produced with designated attributes subject to selection. Hundreds of thousands of frozen embryos are preserved between life and death in liquid nitrogen. International man-made law denies legal protection to the life of the unborn child. More and more countries are legalizing euthanasia. The attack on marriage and the family is increasing.
Najświętsza Matko, obiecujemy Ci ze wszystkich sił. Będziemy chronić ludzkie życie, zwłaszcza małe i bezbronne. Stajemy przed Tobą, Matko Zbawiciela, z pełną świadomością, że sami nie jesteśmy w stanie wygrać tego globalnego zmagania. Stań na czele ruchów obrony życia i chroni nas. Ochroń nas, ocal rodziny i dodaj nam sił. Uproś u swojego Syna zwycięstwo cywilizacji, życia i miłości.
Such moving and important experiences were completed in a prayer by the evening Apel Jasnogórski.
Let me just say a few words to our brothers who came from the Church of the Orthodox Patriarch of Moscow.
И отсюда возьмите Матерь Божию на Святую Русскую землю. Я очень рад, что вот из Востока, вот и Восток, начинается такой настоящий паломнический путь Матери Божией. Все всегда на этом месте. Ночью рано туда, где приезжали.